Hello, my name is Sophie Roeland and I work at the University of Ghent in the Imbio Research Lab. I also work in the BioBase Europe Pilot Plant, a scale-up facility in the port of Ghent. I will be explaining you about biosurfactants, but for that I will first explain what surfactants actually are, where they are applied and how they work. You will also learn about the sourcing of surfactants, so this means which raw materials are currently used for their production, and also how this relates to their labeling. We will then zoom in on so-called bio-based surfactants or biosurfactants and explain what are the different types of bio-based surfactants. I will also give some examples. Now, first things first, where do you think surfactants are actually applied? You might have never heard about the word surfactant, but actually you have used or even eaten several products today that contain surfactants, as they are actually an active ingredient in a very broad range of products we use in our daily lives. If we then take a look at the global market of surfactants, which corresponds in total to about 20 million tons, you can see that a very big part of it is actually the use in so-called household detergents, which are the products you and I use in our houses to clean, wash the dishes, etc. Now that you know that you come in contact with surfactants actually every day, you might wonder what is actually the function of surfactants in all these very diverse products. Well, surfactants are M5-philic molecules, which means that they are a bit schizophrenic. On the one hand, they have a so-called hydrophilic or water-loving part, which wants to interact with water. On the other hand, they have a so-called hydrophobic part or oil-loving part, which wants to interact with oil or other hydrophobic substances, such as, for example, dirt. Now, how does this property relate to the use of a surfactant? Well, imagine you have a dirty pan. You cooked some nice meal and you want to wash the pan afterwards, but you ran out of soap. As oil and water do not mix, it will be very difficult to get the pan clean. While when using soap, you will quite easily wash away the oil. This degreasing or cleansing effect of soap is actually attributed to surfactants in the soap, which help to dissolve the oil in the water by forming so-called micelles. The hydrophobic part of the surfactant will interact with the oil, while the hydrophilic part will interact with the water. And small oil-containing balloons or micelles will form, and as such you will easily wash away the oil with the water. Now, the opposite can also happen with other types of surfactants. For example, for making lotions or creams, the major phase of the cream is oily. And so in this case, the surfactant will enable the generation of so-called inversed micelles to add products to your body lotion which cannot mix with the oil and will thus be trapped in little water balloons containing the water and the water-soluble products. Now, knowing surfactants are a very big market, you might wonder what they are actually produced from. Well, today, a bit less than half of the produced surfactants are fully derived from fossil resources. These surfactants are called non-bio-based surfactants. More than half of the market are these so-called partly bio-based surfactants, which are partly derived from, for example, plants or animal fats. A last and small part of the market are the so-called fully bio-based surfactants, which are 100% bio-based. The fact that we speak about less than 5 and more than 95% and not 0 and 100% is purely attributed to the error margin of the method to determine the origin of the carbon. And this is done by so-called carbon 14 analysis. An example of a non-bio-based surfactant is LAS. This product is mainly used in detergents and laundry detergents. An example of a partly bio-based surfactant is SDS. You can find this widely applied surfactant in toothpaste and shampoo or body wash. The fully bio-based surfactants or biosurfactants are defined by Europe as surfactants which are entirely derived from biomass. Thank you, and I hope you're interested to learn more.